Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it is really my pleasure to participate in this distinguished gathering and important forum, sharing with you some thoughts on the Kuwait Foundation for the Advancement of Sciences, KFAS, and its role, whereby during the next few minutes, I will shed some light on the issues of science and technology from the perspective of the Kuwait Foundation for the Advancement of Sciences, and go briefly through its major activities. KFAS is a private and a non-profit organization established by an Amiri decree issued on the 12th of December, 1976. KFAS is managed by a board of directors chaired by His Highness the Emir of the State of Kuwait, Sheikh Sabah al-Ahmed al-Jaber al-Sabah. Financial contributions are received from Kuwaiti shareholding companies, which form the main source of KFAS fund, and it amounts to 1% of the annual net profit of those companies. This is one of the most important and unique features of KFAS, which is very rare to find a similar setup, not only in the Arab world, but even globally, whereby the private sector contributes voluntarily to the development of science and technology in the country. One of the foremost goals of KFAS is to promote scientific development in the state of Kuwait by supporting scientific projects, the scientific community, and the country's scientific infrastructure. Therefore, promoting science and technology through funding R&D in basic and applied science is one of the major objectives of KFAS, together with encouraging intellectual scientific innovations and disseminating and popularizing science and technology values and practices, as well as establishing bridges of cooperation with international institutions and universities. KFAS is a standalone institution that, through other organizational arrangements, owns other operational satellite units, such as a publishing company, the Scientific Center, and Desman Institute for Diabetes, and Sheikh Sabah al-Ahmed Center for the Gifted and Talented, which has just been recently established. In addition, we are working also on establishing a scientific TV channel. Ladies and gentlemen, in order to fulfill the objectives of KFAS, a wide range of programs and activities have been undertaken since the establishment 34 years ago. This include, among others, funding research and development, prizes, publications in Arabic through authorship and translation, conferences and workshops, training programs, grants, scientific competitions, production of scientific documentary films, and funding patents, registration, and innovation. Since its establishment as a major contribution towards enhancing science and technology through recognizing scientific achievements of Kuwaitis and Arabs, KFAS established the Kuwait Prizes Program. The prizes are awarded for Arab scholars everywhere in the globe. All KFAS prizes include monetary contributions presented along with the KFAS Shield, medals, and certificate of appreciation. The Kuwait Prizes Program includes several prizes. However, the most important one is the Kuwait Prize, which is the most prestigious prize and the oldest scientific prize in the Arab world, that is awarded to the Arab scholars everywhere in the globe for their outstanding achievements, scientific achievements. It is worthwhile mentioning that until now, approximately 500 scholars have been granted KFAS prizes. Ladies and gentlemen, as part of KFAS' effort to widen its contacts with renowned international organizations through partnerships, the Office of International Programs at KFAS established several cooperation programs with reputable international institutions in the United States and in Europe, such as Harvard University, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT, Oxford University, Cambridge University, the Academy of Science for the Developing World, TWAS, the Abdus-Salam International Center for Theoretical Physics, and recently with the London School of Economics in the UK and Sciences Po in France. The scope of these programs include, among others, professorships, fellowships, scholarship exchange, R&D, training, and customized workshops. As for our relationships with the Abdus-Salam International Center for Theoretical Physics, an agreement between KFAS and the center was signed in 1981 to provide scientists from the developing world with opportunities to conduct research and to study new developments in physics and mathematics. This agreement was modified in 2007 to cover the current and the future needs and to broaden the opportunities for others to be part of this distinguished institution through supporting two calendar activities at SCTP and contributing and engaging scientists from Muslim countries to be part of SCTP's scientific programs annually, which covers sponsoring two diploma students according to SCTP's norms. Approximately 380 researchers and scientists have visited SCTP under the KFAS mentorship. And since 2007, six students have joined the diploma program and two are ongoing since September 2010. In addition, our support was extended in the 80s and 90s to cover another related institution, the Academy of Sciences for the Developing World, twice, in its endowment fund and its yearly publications. Distinguished guests and colleagues. In conclusion, KFAS during the last 34 years has conducted a wide range of programs that aim at enhancing science and technology in the state of Kuwait and Arab countries, and fostering technology transfer through effective participation in indigenous technological capacity building and innovation incubation. However, KFAS will continue to explore new frontiers and initiatives in the holistic scene of science and technology, aiming at putting science and technology in action for serving the nation and for the sustainable development. I hope, ladies and gentlemen, that I managed to shed some light on KFAS activities and programs, and I'd like to thank the organizers of this remarkable gathering. Thank you very much.